What would be the modern approach to product protection? What is the role of multifunctional ingredients? Hi everyone, I'm Sabrina Mizel and I'm happy to welcome you back today for a new masterclass episode about the secret heroes of personal care, where we explore the fabulous world of major yet discrete ingredients. In today's class, we'll continue to reflect on why we need product protection and how it can be achieved successfully. Remember that our heroes are fighting against bad microorganisms. Microorganisms are present on all natural surfaces, including human skin. We cannot avoid contact with them, so it becomes obvious that cosmetic products are also exposed and must resist to microbial contaminations. That's why we need to protect products to avoid spoilage caused by bacterial growth. Concretely, contamination of a cosmetic product can occur at different stages caused by the introduction and following growth of microorganisms. These microorganisms, such as yeast, mold, and bacteria, can be brought inside a product already during the production processes or because of poor packaging. Even after the product was purchased, contamination can occur as customers usually touch and apply the product with their hands or store it in warm and humid conditions, like in a bathroom. Ideal conditions for microbial growth are provided. Even though the contact of the product to the customer can be minimized using clever packaging, pumps instead of an open lid, or one-way use packaging, none of these attempts can eliminate the risk of microbial contaminations. Microorganisms are everywhere. But there are solutions. Formulators realized a long time ago that specific ingredients inhibit the growth of microorganisms effectively. We call them preservatives. And even though the mode of action of each of them differs, they succeed in protecting a formulation from spoilage. This can be described as a classical approach towards product protection. Preservatives prevent bacterial growth either during manufacturing process or while being used by the consumer. In order to be effective, they should have a broad spectrum activity against yeast, bacteria, and mold, remain effective over a long period of time, be compatible with the product composition, and do not present any health risks during use. Examples of common preservatives are potassium sorbate, sodium benzoate, aromatic alcohols, or parabens. Most people know about preservatives and their effectiveness, but consumers increasingly demand more benefits from ingredients than merely product protection. That's a challenge for the hero that we call multifunctional ingredients. Multifunctional ingredients are versatile molecules offering multiple benefits to a formula while helping with product protection. They might act as solubilizers, soothing agents, humectants, or aesthetic enhancers, and that's only a few of the long list of possible benefits. Adding multifunctionals allows you to get more benefits with fewer ingredients. And let's not forget about the supporting part they play in the product protection mission. In smart combinations, multifunctionals enhance the efficacy of traditional preservatives and allows lower use levels. Amongst multifunctionals, you might have heard of 1,2-alkandiols, hydroxyacetophenone, or alkylglycerol ethers. And today, there even are green versions of these versatile molecules available. This great toolbox of multifunctional properties broadens the possibility of any formulator to generate a versatile product with numbers of benefits while shortening ink list and reducing development time. All of these customer costs reduces ingredient inventory at the manufacturing site and lowers the impact on the environment. That's why, when designing a formulation, a formulator should always consider at the beginning of the project the different benefits of multifunctionals to maximize the potential of these powerful molecules. With the introduction of multifunctionals, there are now many ways to enhance the protection of a formulation. You might choose only preservatives, or choose multifunctional ingredients, or a combination of both ingredient types. The increased number of options may allow formulators as well as consumers to have a wider range of options for safe and well-protected products. I hope you enjoy learning more about our heroes of the season. It's been a pleasure telling you a part of their story. And because there are many ways to protect your personal care formulations, you'll learn a lot more about our secret heroes in the next episode. Thank you.
Symrise. Always inspiring more.